Hey, what's up, man? I just got another pizza for us. You can go ahead and get that. Yo, man, what are you doing? Are you cooking right now?
Bro, you really ordered a pizza?
Man, you fat, bro.
Bro, don't even get me started, bro, because I'll be roasting on your fat self too, bro.
Yeah, I'm over here cooking up some of this food that HelloFresh sent me, man.
What are you talking about? What's HelloFresh?
Hey, man, HelloFresh is a company that sends you fresh food from the farm straight to your door.
Man, you know I don't be paying attention to none of that stuff. All I do is just get pizza, man.
Let's just say this. You know the holidays can be hectic, right? But when it comes to HelloFresh, with them sending the ingredients and the recipes to you, it makes it so much more simpler by cutting out all that grocery and meal prep time, man. So you can spend more time with your friends and family for the holidays. And then also they can eat that nice, fresh, and healthy food that you just got from HelloFresh.
Oh, wow. That definitely sounds fresh.
And it sends you so many different recipes each and every week. So you always have that different variety every single time that you eat HelloFresh.
Go on.
Yo, bro, HelloFresh offers up to 50 different menu and market items, just providing you with that variety. And then you know with your weekly delivery, it's supposed to help you with cutting back on that meal prep time and the cleanup.
Hey, yo, that's actually pretty cool that they do that, because then you don't have to get bored with whatever diet that you're doing.
HelloFresh also makes eating so much easier with family-friendly, calorie-smart, vegetarian, and pescatarian options, just to name a few. Now, I've actually been wanting to use HelloFresh for a while now, so I'm really happy that I'm finally getting that chance to experience it. It's really been helping me on staying on that pathway of eating healthy and living a better life, which is one of the goals that I have set for myself right now. And another thing that I'm happy about is just the different variety of foods that they send each and every week, which is good for me because I also want to open my horizon when it comes to the certain foods that I eat, because I'm tired of eating the same things over and over again now. HelloFresh also comes with pre-portioned ingredients, which helps you with less prep time and it helps you waste less food. Now, if any of you want to try out HelloFresh, just go to HelloFresh.com, put in my code MelVerse14, and you can get up to 14 free meals plus 3 free gifts. Now, once again, go to HelloFresh.com, type in my code MelVerse14, you get 14 free meals plus 3 free gifts. Now, let's go ahead and get into this video, man. But hold on, wait. I just remember something, bro. You don't even know how to cook.
No, wait, what?
What are you talking? Why would you even bring that up, man? They don't even need to know that. What are you talking about? Ads over. Don't even worry about it now. No. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Mello. Man, do y'all know how hard it was to find this damn movie? That's one of the reasons why it took me so long to watch it. But I really wanted to do this movie now to start off the holiday month of December, man. Because it gave me this feel, you know, looking at it, you know, especially with the poster and everything. So I'm excited for this month. Oh, go ahead and like this video, share, comment down below, and subscribe. Make sure you click that bell. Now let's go ahead and get into this movie reaction.
Yo, they got like this fog machine sound effect, and then you got the clouds right here. It feels like I'm flying, especially how the music was just slowly getting louder and stuff too. I've never heard the full song of this. Fly a fantasy. Man, and I like that opening music, man. It gets you hyped for this movie. Let you know what type of movie you're heading into.
I had another dream, Dad, about Mom.
Dang, so this must have happened recently. Yeah, I know they're going through a real rough time.
Bastion, we each have responsibilities.
I feel
be an excuse for not getting the old job done, right?
This dude drinking orange juice and eggs? Orange juice and raw eggs. Ew. Or is he just drinking straight raw eggs?
She says that you are drawing horses in your math book.
Unicorns.
How the hell is he doing it?
Now, Bastion, you're old enough to get your head down out of the clouds. And
I mean, I understand his dad is trying to keep him to go forward and stuff, but you gotta understand, man, his mom just passed away and he's a little kid. That's tough. But you know, what can you do as a dad, man? You can't keep coddling him.
Hey, weirdo. Got any cash for us today?
Get up!
They really gonna bully this kid right here in this busy-ass intersection.
Where's your money, man?
I don't have it!
No money?
Man, he got to communicate this with his father. You know, I know there's a lot of kids that go through this. See, situations like that is why some people be doing the things they be doing, man. You got to communicate. And then the father got to be a father and, like, actually pay attention and listen. And
you're hiding, aren't you? The video arcade is down the street. Here we just sell small rectangular objects. They're called books. Require a little effort on your part and make no beep, 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 beeps.
They want to throw me in the garbage.
So why don't you give him a good punch in the nose?
Because they jump in his ass. But I mean, I understand what he's saying, because I would try to punch one or two of them. You feel me? You're going to take me out swinging.
Have you ever been Captain Nemo trapped inside your submarine while the giant squid is attacking you?
Man, this old man has seen some shit.
Yes.
In these books.
Forget about it. This book is not for you.
He wants this kid to steal this book. Like, everything you said is having this kid tempted to steal this book.
Well, they run maybe 300, 370.
I mean, it's in a book, so I guess. I don't. Nobody's, like, saying it verbally. They might say it later on. I don't know. Like, to me, the song doesn't count. Oh, so he was doing it on purpose.
Math test.
Damn, and you late? You already know that's an automatic zero. The hell is that? King Kong on a bulldozer? What the hell? Or I don't know what that thing is called. Oh, I thought that was a part of his body for a second. Yo, look at this. This is crazy.
Where I come from in the north, we used to have exquisite gourmet rocks. Only now, they're all gone.
Damn, y'all fat asses ate all the damn rocks?
It was gone.
Did the lake dry up?
No, it just wasn't there anymore.
Yo, what's up with this? This audio dub, man.
We are on the same mission. After all, if the Empress can't save us, who could?
He was in that Willy Wonka movie. He was one of the Oompa Loompas, the one with Johnny Depp. And it's crazy because he's dressed like Willy Wonka in this movie. This dude is hang gliding on a bat, man.
There he is.
I never knew it was that beautiful.
Yo, that is beautiful, man. That is a nice design. That looked like something that'll be on the poster.
Stay awake.
How you flying and you sleep? Yo, what is your favorite 80s kids movie? Because I'm really liking the art design here, just like I was liking the art design in Flash Gordon.
The nothing is destroying our world. I also know that you have come to beseech the Empress for help.
Oh, man, look at these designs, bro. Oh, man. They are killing it in this movie already. I really feel like I'm in a different world just by this art design here, man. Oh, there go that little boy. Oh, snap. Where the dog dragon at, or the dragon dog, whatever.
You would be willing to go on a quest?
What kind of a quest?
To find a cure for the Empress.
Is there any chance of success?
No. Man, you should be asking yourself that. Why would you ask him that? Come on, man. Don't be having no doubt in yourself. As soon as you have doubt, the mission has already failed. Now, that emblem is fire.
He who wears the Orin speaks for the Empress.
Yo, and it got gold, and I'm guessing that's like onyx or something.
Ooh,
probably go to the club or something like that. You're like, damn, this is a good-ass book, man.
A creature of darkness also began his quest. They had been traveling aimlessly for almost a week.
Yo, look, man, this set looks real. Y'all probably gonna hear me talk about the set design and the art design a lot with this movie, because I'm really blown away by this stuff.
It's time to eat. Good idea.
No, it's a great idea.
What the hell was that? Gee, Willikers, man, that's a great idea. Time to eat lunch.
Not too much. We still have a long way to go.
He's invested in this book. Okay, he think he actually there. Yeah, that's how you know it's a good book. Pretty much, I'll be doing the same thing with movies. I'll be acting like I'm in the movie.
And so there was only one chance left to find Morla, the ancient one, somewhere in the deadly swamps of sadness.
Y'all couldn't walk around or something?
Whoever let the sadness overtake him would sink into the swamp.
Yo, so this is like a depression swamp or something.
What's the matter?
That horse is sad, man. You better start sinking. You better tell him a joke or something. Come on, man.
Come on! Artex! Fight against the sadness, Artex!
You have to try. You have to care.
Yeah, motivate the horse, man. Yeah, give him a hug and a kiss. Damn, man, that is so sad. I really just saw his friend die right there in front of him. Well, you really crying? We just met the horse. We barely spent time with him. I understand it's messed up, and the music they was playing in the background was fantastic. That was some powerful music. It definitely had me feeling something, but I wasn't connected to that horse like that. I understand that it's an animal, so automatically you feel something for animals. Piece of music right here is giving me some Mass Effect vibes. Ah! Like, who the hell was that? The hell are you screaming for?
We haven't spoken to anyone else for thousands of years.
Oh, hell no, Morley. You better cover your damn mouth.
If I don't save her, she'll die. There's a terrible nothing sweeping over the land. Don't you care about that?
We don't even care.
Marla, I had my mouth open that damn time, man. You need to chill the hell out.
You can ask the Southern Oracle.
How can I get there?
It's 10,000 miles away.
Well, carry my ass over there with your crazy ass. I mean, that was just a lost cause, to be honest. That was really a waste of time. I don't even know why he would try to persuade her, beg her to help him. She hasn't talked to anybody in a long time. She has lost her mind. She's crazy. She don't give a damn about nothing because she's not attached to nothing. She's been on her own for the longest. Are you telling me the school day is over with and you're staying in the school, boy, if you don't go home?
No, Atreyu wouldn't quit now.
Man, it's a damn book. You can read the book in your room. Whenever I've seen trailers and TV spots for this movie or whatever, I always thought that the movie was just about this kid. I didn't think the movie had another kid reading a book about this kid. I thought we was just already in this world. Or I thought he got like transported into this world, kind of like the Chronicles of Narnia or something. There he go! Oh, I guess you can see those two dogs like heaven and hell. Ooh, okay. I didn't know he had that on him. Dude got like pearl skin or pearl scales or something. Yeah. I don't like how he smiled when he did that. That was kind of creepy.
Leaving so soon.
Oh, that face looks weird now. It looks like a pervert or something.
I was trying to
sneak away.
Yeah. I mean, no.
I like children.
For breakfast?
Nah, he like them for never. Other stuff. Oh, he winked.
Get round and scratch behind my right ear.
Yeah, I bet you would want me to do that, you freaking pervert.
Yeah.
Yo, bro.
That's so good.
How'd all this happen?
With luck.
Stop winking at me, man. Oh my god, I don't like that laugh, bro. Like you checking me out when I'm walking away. Ugh. What's up with this damn dragon dog? He's like, oh yeah, he bent over. I know some people might get upset about that because, you know, this is their childhood. But I mean, I'm an adult now, man, and I'm seeing this from an adult perspective. If I was seeing this as a kid, I probably wouldn't be feeling this way.
He's well.
Oh man, you might as well let it go, man.
Oh, now you go.
Let it go, bro. You got that one tooth hanging? Just take that shit out, bro.
Have you ever been to the Southern Arc?
I work scientifically.
Yo, the whole sizing perspective they've been doing throughout this whole movie is cool, man.
Let's see what he really thinks of himself. Look, look. Oh, it's my turn. Let me see. I'm the scientist.
Man, you can use this any other day, man. Let me use it, bro.
I think he's gonna make it.
Let me see.
Man, bro, let me see, bro. Golly, you the one who live here. Huh, look like that's some type of security thing or whatever.
Listen, boy. Next time, let me see what happens. It's my telescope.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to see, because it's your telescope, bitch. Golly, you can see any other day. You stingy motherfucker. Oh, damn, they burnt this dude. I get hype off that scene right there, man. This soundtrack is fire. Oh, he can see him.
This is going too far.
Oh, you starting to understand what that old man was saying, huh? Yeah. Yeah. Hopefully his father is looking for him.
Then you must know what can save Fantasia.
The Empress. Please,
that's all? But that's easy!
Yeah, just change your damn name!
No one from Fantasia can do it. Only a human child.
I'm gonna be honest, that sounds kind of stupid. But they like, she can't change her name. Like, nah, the little kid reading the book gotta change her name. Who the hell said that? The screenwriter? Oh my goodness. Or the author, whoever. You're a dragon dog and you can't sniff my scent? You ass, Falcor.
They look like big, good, strong hands, don't they? I couldn't hold on to them. I failed.
No, you didn't fail.
Yes, he did. Nah, he's a rock, and you telling me you couldn't hold on to him? Yeah, he failed. Yo, what the hell are you doing, bruh? Oh, that's a nice shot right there, him standing in the light. That looked like something they put in the trailer. He's starting to see the story. How ironic is it to call a movie The Never-Ending Story, but it ends? He's like, spoiler alert. Why are you looking like you're taking a shit?
I will rip you to shreds.
Sound like the same voice actor who did Falcor.
Every part, every creature of it is a piece of the dreams and hopes of mankind.
Damn, that's a fourth wall break if I ever heard one.
But why is Fantasia dying then?
Because people have begun to lose their hopes.
What is the nothing?
Video games, social media, the internet. Nobody wants to read books anymore.
Because people who have no hopes are easy to control. And whoever has the control has the power.
He's speaking facts, man. He got him some quotables right there.
I was sent to kill the only one. His name was Atreyu.
He's like, damn, I don't know who that is.
Trail!
Damn, why you say that, bruh? Damn, that nothing is strong. For it to be nothing. Okay, I can see why that rock lost his friends. Dang, it's like destroying the whole world. You in this dirty ass attic chilling and stuff like you at home? Well, you're probably gonna get sick.
Go on.
Winking at me. Man, I'm about to whoop your ass, bro. Wink at me one more time, bro. Oh, that's that little girl. She's been on all the damn posters and stuff.
I have failed you, Empress.
You haven't.
You know about the Earthling child?
I knew everything.
So why the hell would you go me on this whole damn trip?
For what?
Exactly.
To find out what you already knew?
Exactly.
What?
That's exactly what I'll be like, what? I'm like, man, fuck this damn book. So I guess they wanted the kid to build a connection with this character and this world for him to be able to help them.
They were with him when he hid from the boys in the bookstore.
Oh my God, this stuff is really breaking through the walls right here. So she's talking about me now? Mind blown, yo. Why is this boy taking so long? Just call out the name.
Bastion, call my name.
The hell is going on?
Bastion.
I'm sorry, kid. Can you speak that again? I can't hear a word you were saying. The storm was overpowering you.
What is that?
It's like the Big Bang.
One grain of sand. Fantasia can arise in you.
I mean, why don't you just start from chapter one and wouldn't the world just be back to normal?
And my first wish is...
Why would you do this, little kid? Oh, I was about to say, bruh. Nobody sees this? Wow, so Fantasia is real. That's awesome, man. Yeah, they definitely not gonna bully him no more. Oh, for? Oh, that's the end?
Never-ending story.
Was cool. It's just one of those movies that it entertains you and stuff. You know, you don't want to think that much into it because there was a lot of dumb stuff in this movie. Hey, it's all right. I like the soundtrack, the art design, the set design. It was all amazing, man. I did not like the dog. I was like so excited to see the dog and everything. Turns out that dog is just a pervert. When I put a poll up for people and they chose for me to watch this movie, somebody put in the comments that the reason why they never remake this movie is because the original author did not like what they did with this movie here and he chose for nobody to be able to remake this movie or whatever. But I have a feeling that if somebody was to remake this movie, I think they would do a way better job than what they did here in the original. Okay, everybody, and that was the never-ending story that obviously ended, which is crazy to call something that. I mean, it is a nice title though. This is just a beautiful looking movie. Just the effects, the design, the whole aesthetic of it was nice to see. I'm really happy that I finally got to see this classic here and just to see what it is that everybody loves about this movie and why it is a classic. The acting wasn't good. The story was okay, but towards the end, I'm like, oh, what? What the fuck? But it was entertaining. The soundtrack was amazing. I mean, there's nothing else to really say. I understand that this movie is pretty much catered towards kids. It's a PG rated film. I know kids love this movie. I don't even know if kids of today watches this movie. I really liked the kid Atreyu. He seemed like a real likable kid. The audio dub was awful. I don't know what they was going for when it comes to that dog. As soon as I saw him smile when he opened his eye, just the way his face looked, it just looked creepy to me. And ever since then, I just got this vibe where I was like, I don't know, man. But it was hilarious at the same time. I want to let y'all know right now, I'm not shitting on the movie or anything. I understand that this movie is a lot of people's childhood and all that stuff. I'm not shitting on the movie. I'm just letting y'all know what I saw and how I feel. I'll give this movie here a 7B+. I really hope that y'all enjoyed watching this video and watching this movie with me. You know, please share, like, comment down below, subscribe, click the bell so you know when I upload more videos. You can follow me on all my social medias.
All the links will be in the description. If you want to see my full-length movie reaction, Patreon will be in the description as well. Also, I want to go ahead again and thank HelloFresh for sponsoring this video, man. I'm so happy that I finally got like a really big promotion right here, and it's really nice. You know, try them out. The code will be in the description as well. Man, I always wanted to do HelloFresh, like I said, and it's really nice that I have a chance to do it and to meal prep and all that stuff, because, you know, I gotta get in shape and everything. But with all that being said, I'll see you on the next one. All right, peace.